Oh, had I a golden thread and needle so fine, I'd weave a magic strand of rainbow design, of rainbow design. Far over the waters, I'd reach my magic band to every human being, so they would understand. So
well, here we are again, once again exploring all the different colors and kinds of people that there are, and it's a lot. On other programs, we've had people from different languages, different races and religions, and today also. Of course, this isn't a serious thing, this Rainbow Quest, because the whole idea of music is to have fun. Of course, you can get in trouble sometimes, but, well, I'll show you what I mean. It's a story, a little story, has a song go along with it. Once upon a time, there was a farmer walking down the road. He was whistling this tune to himself, but he scratched his head and says, "Doggone, I wish I had some words to that song, and I don't have any words, just the tune." Just then he came to a little brook, and he leans on the railing of the bridge and he looks down. There's a big old bullfrog hopping from bank to bank. Well, the bullfrog looked up, and he saw the farmer looking at him, and he decided he'd show off. He took an extra special big hop. Kersplash, he fell in the mud, got all dirty. The farmer laughed and started singing. Way down south in the yankety-yank, a bullfrog jumped from bank to bank just because there's nothing better for to do. He stubbed his toe and he fell in the water. You could hear him holler for a mile and a quarter just because there's nothing better for to do. Now the farmer went down the road feeling mighty proud of himself making up a song. Went down to the corner store, bought himself a plug of chewing tobacco and some groceries, a pair of work gloves. He says, "Oh, before I go home, I must teach him a new song." The man in the store says, "Go home, I'm busy here." The farmer says, "I won't pay you my money unless you let me sing my song." "All right," says the store manager, "sing it and get it over with." Well, the farmer started singing. The man in the store says, "Hey, that's a pretty good tune. Gather around, everybody. We'll have a party." And they were stamping on the floor, singing away down south and the yankety-yank, a bullfrog jumped from bank to bank. And they were stamping on the floor, drinking the free Coca-Colas, eating the free soda crackers. Now, back home, in every farmhouse, children was about to sit down to eat supper, and mother says, "Children, you better run down to the corner store and fetch your old man. He's probably wasting his time as usual." So all the children ran down the road. They ran inside the store. They heard that music. They forgot all about giving the message. The children started singing, "We don't south in the yankety yank, a bullfrog jumped from bank to bank." And they were stamping on the floor, drinking the free Coca-Colas, eating the free soda. In every farmhouse, it was the same situation. The mother says, "This has gone on far enough. Do they expect us to work all day and nobody show up?" And they walk down the road, waving the frying pans. Well, they get near, they hear that pretty music coming out of the corner store, and they forget about being angry. They drop the frying pans in the gutter. They walk in the store, and the mother starts singing, "Way down south in the yankety-yank, a bullfrog jumped from bank to bank." And they were stamping on the floor, drinking the free Coca-Cola, eating the... Out in the barn, all the cows says,
"Where is everybody? We're supposed to be milked. It's getting very uncomfortable."
All the cows walked out of their stalls. They walked down the road. They walked inside the corner store, and the cows start moo, 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 cow's tails were swishing out the window. They were stamping on the floor and drinking the free Coca-Colas and eating the free soda crackers. Out in the barnyard, all the chickens says,
"Where is everybody? We're supposed to be fed. We're getting hungry."
So the chickens hopped over the fence. They hopped down the road. They hopped inside the corner store. Feathers flying through the air, and the chickens were stamping on the floor, drinking the free Coca-Colas, drinking the free soda crack. All the barns now started talking to each other. They said, "We feel so empty without any cows, without any chickens." And the barns picked themselves off their foundation. They glumped down the road, believe it or not. They squeezed themselves right inside that corner store. Did you ever hear a rusty hinge on a barn door? That's the way they sang. Out in the fields, all the grass says, "Where is everybody? The cows are supposed to come and eat us. I guess we'll have to go find them." So the grass picked itself up, swished down the road, swished up inside the corner store. When the grass was gone, the fields were gone. When the fields were gone, the banks of the brook were gone. The brook says, "I don't have nothing to bubble between." So the brook bubbled down the road, bubbled up inside the corner store. The brook was bubbling up and down the stairway. The grass was growing out the chimney. The feathers flying through the air, and the cow's tail swishing out the window. Everybody drinking the free Coca-Cola, eating the free soda cracker. There was the bullfrog now in midair. He looks down. There was absolutely nothing underneath him. He looks over. There's no bank to land on. He says, "Where am I?" The only thing left was the road. He got up on it and started hopping down the road. He got near to the corner store. He says, "Hey, what's that racket down there?" He's the only honest one. It was a racket. He says, "Why, they're singing." He says, "They're singing about me." And the frog was so proud, he puffed himself up with pride. And he puffed. And he puffed. And he puffed, and he puffed, and he, pooh, he exploded all directions. Cows, barns, chickens, farmers, wives, children, the whole corner store went up in the air. And everybody floated down, landed right where they're supposed to have been the whole time, sat down eating supper, feeling kind of foolish for themselves. Next day, they went out to try and find the frog. They looked high, they looked low, Coca-Cola bottles and soda crackers in all directions, but no frog. So all there is left of the frog is the song. We might as well sing it once again. Away down south in the Yankety Yank, a bullfrog jumped from bank to bank just because there's nothing better for to do. He stubbed his toe and he fell in the water. You could hear him holler for a mile and a quarter just because there's nothing better for to do. Anybody know how to whistle? And whistle along. That story was told me when I was about 6 years old by my father. Now, we didn't live way back in the Kentucky mountains. It was right here in New York State. My father's a professor of musicology, but he remembered that tune from when he'd been a kid, and he made up the story to go around it. And I often think of this when people ask me, "How do you learn folk songs?" I say, "Well, you can learn them out of books. There are lots of good books. You can learn them off records. Lots of good records. Learn them from other people. But you know, you can learn some of your best songs right from your own family sometimes." Well, a person says to me, my family's mostly from Poland or Italy or someplace. I say, "Well, there's an awful lot of good Polish folk songs. There's an awful lot of good Italian folk songs." And because the whole idea of this rainbow quest is we're searching out the various colors and kinds of people, we're going to sing lots of songs in different languages, different nations, races, religions. And I can't always speak a full of the language well, but I know that I've learned something by singing songs that are not in the English language. For example, here's a song. It's in Yiddish. I hope I pronounce it right. I may not, but I'll try my best. As men for Sevastopol is not weit von Simferopol, Dorken is a stancia faran. Wer da versuchen eigentlich in diese Stancia an, an die Klinjankaya, Jan, Jan, Jan. Hey, Jan, hey, Jankaya, Jan, Billy, Jankaya, hey, Jankaya, Jan, Jan, Jan. Hey, Jan, hey, Jankaya, Jan, Billy, Jankaya, hey, Jankaya, Jan, Jan, Jan. Fährt jeden Neufmann Kasche, wie's mein Bruder, wie's a Brasche, es geht bei ihm der Traktor wie ein Mann. Der Mimmeleia Badeke Silke, Bele Bade, Molle Tilke, Jan Koye, Jan, Jan, Jan. Hey, Jan, hey, Jan Koye, Jan Billy, Jan Koye, hey, Jan Koye, Jan, Jan, Jan. Hey, Jan, hey, Jan Koye, Jan Billy, Jan Koye, hey, Jan Koye, Jan, Jan, Jan. Jocht sich jeden kennen, nor handeln, essen, flatter, reich mit Mandeln, nor nit sein kein Arbeitsmann. Das können sorgen, nor die Sonne, jeden Speize, on im Bonim, tuka kuk auf Jan, Jan, Jan. Hey, Jan, hey, Jan, koi, Jan, Billy, Jan, koi, Jan, koi, Jan, Jan, Jan. Hey, Jan, hey, Jan, koi, Jan, Billy, Jan, koi, hey, Jan, koi, Jan. Now, I wasn't raised to that kind of music, but I heard that song about 17 years ago, sung by some young people in New York, and I loved it so much, I tried learning it. I found out they got it out of a book of Jewish folk songs, and I thought maybe in a moment you'd like to meet the woman who put together that book, because she spent a whole lifetime collecting Yiddish folk songs from around the world. Her name is Ruth Rubin, and you'll meet her in just a moment. I'm talking to Ruth Rubin, who's one of the foremost folklorists in the field of Yiddish folk songs in the whole world. She's an old friend of mine. We've known each other for many, many years. And Ruth, first of all, did I pronounce the words more or less okay? Understandable?
I think you did very well.
I get in an argument sometime. I found there's two or three different ways to pronounce Yiddish. Is that right?
Why, yes. The same as with English? No.
Oh, that's right.
Yes.
How did you get started collecting Jewish folk songs?
Well, right in the family, right in the home. My mother did an awful lot of singing. And it's true that when I first heard her, I wasn't a collector then. But I became a collector much later, and I began not with Yiddish, but with Negro folk music.
I'll be done.
American folk music, everything but my own. And then an old friend said, "You are a queer one. You have all of this in your own home and your own environment, and you just are passing it by." So I said, "Well, now." And that started me. And I found such a treasure that I never let go. And then I found, after many years, that all of that related to the songs I knew before, which meant it related to world folk song. I had had a large collection by then.
Give me a for instance.
Well, even if you took a little simple song like a ring game that my mother taught me, which is something like Farmer in the Dell. You know Farmer in the Dell. Farmer in the Dell, and so on. Yes. Well, in the Yiddish environment, which meant Eastern Europe 150 years ago or 100 years ago, the children played a ring game in which everyone was going to a wedding. And it would start like this. Spitz boy dem sidre tolle stibel khoyski ke tolle betel tsige bet tolle meidel tsige glet tolle fedel khoyski stroyet and so on. And then it would start introducing the various members of the family. Kim taran de rotate, atrafen de kapotalote, kim taran de momme, zucht men zigeet kochen flommen. And the words never really fitted in, and because the rhymes were all spontaneous. And went on and on and on until at the very end, kim taran de bobe, streckt sie us de lobe, kim taran de zeide, geh me tanzen beide. And of course everyone went dancing. And everybody was mentioned, and all the rhymes were spontaneous, and then, as a collector, I found that the song was sung differently in the north in Poland and differently in the south in Bessarabia. My family comes from Bessarabia. And so they had a different kind of rhyming, different kind of expression of Yiddish. They wouldn't say, they'd say lobe in Bessarabia and lape up north in Vilna, see, or bube for grandma, and so on.
What different kinds of songs are there? It seems like we have love songs and story songs.
Oh, yes. After so many years of working, I had to do a book on all of that, you know. And the love songs happen to be the most numerous in our category. Very many love songs, very many.
Sing one.
Well, you know, I would like to sing you one that relates at least to the American migration, when young people left the Tsarist lands in the 80s because of the misery there. They came to the new world to find a new life, to put down new roots, and everything was so wonderful in America, people said. There was equality, there was work for everyone, and so this is a love song in which a young fellow did go off and then is lonely for his sweetheart back home. It goes like this. Hoy dorten dorten neber na vasarul hoy dorten dorten neber brik far tribm hast du mich in die weiten Länderen bänken bänk ich noch dir zurück. Ein Wiffel und Lach zusammen gesessen, ein Wiffel und Lach spät in der Nacht, ein Wiffel Trierlach mir haben vergossen, bis mir haben die Liebe zusammengebracht. Oi, helf mir Gott in you, oi, Gott in Himmel. Oi, helf mir Gott in you, es ist mir nicht geht. Schon in Zeit drei Jura lach, wie mir spielen alle Liebe. Spielen die Liebe kennen wir nicht. Oi, deine Oiga lach, wie die schwarze Kirsche lach, in deine Lippa lach, wie Rose, wie Papier, in deine Finger lach, wie Tinte, wie Feder. Schreiben sollst du oft den Brief zu mir. I should tell you about the last stanza.
What does it mean?
In which she compares her eyes to little black cherries and her lips to pink crepe paper and her fingers to a quill and to write with, long, slender fingers. The pink crepe paper was the days before lipstick.
Oh,
they
sure.
Dipped some paper in water and applied it to the lips.
Oh, be darned. Ah. Did they have songs telling about, well, or referring to events of the day in the way that in America you also have songs? I don't necessarily mean outlaw songs, but in other words, not just a general song, but it somehow refer to actual conditions of the present.
You mean a topical song?
Well, I suppose you'd call it a topical
song. Yeah. Why, of course, people reacted to everything. Everything that happened, whether it was a war, or it was going to America, as I just sang, or somebody drowning, or the topical songs were either specific or they were general. I recall a song about a young girl whose darling was going into the army. She didn't like it. It meant losing the most precious possession in her life. This is all in an atmosphere of great naivete, where marriages were arranged and girls didn't romance naturally as we do now. But this girl apparently had seen her beloved and admired him very much, and she dreaded the moment when he'd go into the army. So she pleads to the Lord, of course, to... She can't understand why her darling must be a soldier. Well, that's topical.
Mm-hmm. How to sing a little of it.
All right. I can sing two stanzas and you'll get the idea. Kein Essen und kein Trinken, Mama, nehmt mich nicht. Ich gehe herum ständig, ständig weinendig. Ich frag nur bei dir, teurer Gott, für was soll sein mein Hosner Soldat? Ah, ich will sich stellen, a Literl. In a Riff kriechen will ich zu Gott. Ich will bei ihm fragen, eine, zwei, drei Wörter, für was soll sein mein Hosner Soldat? Hm. She wants to know why.
Ah,
I
like no why. There's one song that you printed in your book, and I've sung it, in a dozen different countries, because it's got a chorus that anybody can join in on. It's the one of these riddle songs. I guess every country's got riddle songs, and let's get in the key where you can sing it as well as I can.
Not in your high tenor.
Tumbala, 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 tumbala,
Ich will bei dir fragen, was kann wachsen und regen, was kann brennen und nicht aufhören, was kann weinen und tränen.
Say, let's ask anybody that's watching this. You're foolish if you don't sing along with us. Tumbala, tumbalalayka, and I'll get in tune so I can really play it. Clear out your throat, try it. Tumbala, tumbala, tumbalalayka. Tumbala, tumbala, tumbalalayka. Tumbalalayka, spielbalalayka. Tumbalalayka, freilach soll sein.
Ich will bei dir fragen, was kann wachsen und regen, was kann brennen und nicht aufhören, was kann weinen und tränen. Tumbala, tumbala, tumbalalayka. Tumbala, tumbala, tumbalalayka. Tumbalalayka, spielbalalayka. Tumbalalayka, freilach soll sein.
As I understand it, the words mean a boy is standing all night long thinking and thinking what to ask the girl. Finally he says, maiden, maiden, what can grow without rain? What can cry without tears? What can burn without burning itself out? She says, foolish boy. Why do girls always say foolish boy? Don't you know only a stone can grow without rain, but a heart can cry without tears, and love can burn without burning itself out.
Narischer Bocher, was darfst du fragen? A Stein kann wachsen und regen.
Liebe kann brennen und nicht täufeln.
Once more. Tumbala, tumbala, tumbalalayka. Tumbala, tumbala, tumbalalayka. Tumbalalayka, spiel balalayka. Tumbalalayka, freilach so sein.
Chanuke O Chanuke, a yontif a shener, a lustiger, a freilichen Ton, och a zoiner. Alle Nachten dreidel spielen mir, zu de Käselatkes essen mir. Geschwindert sind Kinder, die Chanuke lichterlechon. Lo mir alle singen, dem yontif a singen, en kumt alle singen in Korn. Lo mir alle singen, dem yontif a singen, en kumt alle tanzen in Korn. Jude hat vertrieben dem Söhne dem Razzeich und hat dem Besamigdisch gesungen am Razzeich. Die Stadt Jerusalem hat wieder aufgelebt und zu einem neuen Leben hat jeder geschleppt. Der Rieber, dem Gieber, Jehuda Maccabi läuft hoch, singt mit Betochen wegen dem Nezochen, lieben das Volk so für euch. Singt mit Betochen wegen dem Nezochen und lieben das Volk so für euch.
I never heard a second verse to that before.
Very few people know it. It speaks about the heroism of Judah Maccabeus, who was victorious over the Syrian king Antiochus, 175 B.C. But I like the last line there that says, "Hail the hero Maccabee, but never forget the people love them too." Lieben das Volk soll für euch. That part of it, you know?
I guess every people in the world have these songs about festivals, religious or non-religious. And I like, one of the reasons I always like Christmas songs is because like that, they're so much like dances. I've never played it so well as I did one winter day about 10 years ago. I had borrowed somebody's tape recorder and I had my own, so I tried multiple dubbing and I played guitar against myself. And it turned out so well, I used it as a soundtrack for a little movie I made. Oh, it wasn't a fancy thing, only one grade above home movies, but it was showing how every Christmas time, my children and me and the grandfather paint designs on a newspaper, and then we use it for wrapping presents. Let me show you. Look on the screen, you'll see it.
On newspaper?
Yeah, right on newspaper.
My brother and I push a couple of tables together and paint designs on the newspaper. The idea is not to take too long doing any one of them. The dye sinks right into the newspaper and you can go over it almost right away. Just make it up as you go along. If one idea doesn't work out right, try another.
Thank you.
The grown-ups come in to watch. Before you know it, they're trying their hand at it, too. No two people make the same kind of design. Some want to paint actual pictures, but I think this takes too long. It's better just to use your imagination. Uh-oh. Someone else wants to get in on the act. Well, she can if she wants. We just don't give her the best brushes, because she sometimes pushes them. Actually, any age can have fun with this. As I was saying, no two people are alike. Some like stripes, some like dots, some like, she doesn't know it, but we give her jars filled with vegetable coloring.
Hey, that's pretty.
One of the best in...
Let me show you. This is the kind of brushes we use. Any kind of floppy brush.
But I want to know what kind of paint they're using.
That's important. You don't use poster paint. You use some kind of ink or dye. You can buy it at an art store in a little package of powder, and you pour it into a glass and stir it around. Sometimes add a little vinegar to it to make its colors bright.
Not for the little ones.
Oh, well, for the little ones, we used vegetable coloring because the aniline dye, I don't know, I don't think it's poisonous, but it wouldn't be good to drink it. But the whole idea is you can have so much fun with it. You can make any plaids. Some people make plaids. Oh, it's a pity this isn't color because these are all bright yellow, blue, greens. I can usually recognize which in the family has done every one, whether it's a daughter or her grandfather.
Well, who did this one?
This is her grandfather. This is the 10-year-old. This is me. And this is me. This is her. Oh, this is me. And, you figure it's destined for the garbage can anyway, and so you don't need to be self-conscious. You just fool around and have...
Oh, that's a beauty.
Yeah.
Who's that?
That's my daughter. She's 10 years old now. This is an interesting one because, it starts off by making an ink blob. You know, like a Rorschach, the psychologist test. Well, here, if you listen to my daughter, she explains it later on in the same movie. If you switch on the projector, you can see how he actually makes these designs.
A design by making an ink blot. Here, my brother will show you how it's done. He makes a little puddle of dye in the center of the paper. Now, by folding the paper over on it, he gets an ink blot design. See? Papa calls this the Rorschach.
That's
looks beautiful.
Near the end of the session, my grandfather takes up all the brushes at once. Instead of cleaning them right away, he makes a big smear. Sometimes the result is horrible, but when he does it, I must admit, it usually does look good.
You can see how the little kid was trying to do like her grandfather by putting a whole bundle in her hand. Well, this gets back to what we were talking about, that you can learn from your own family. Of course, it's supposed to be a folk music program. I don't know how we got into all this painting. Stick around. We have time for a few more songs before the program's over. Ruth, are there any songs in the Yiddish tradition which are what I call cumulative? You know, like 12 days of Christmas, it goes ones for this, twos for that, threes for something else. Do you have songs like that?
Oh, yes. Some of the songs are number songs, you know. And we have some during the Passover holiday. But many cumulative songs are things. They may list a number of things and pile up on a mountain like, you know.
Such as
oxen I like very much, where the oxen chop the noodles and the bears sweep the houses and the goats rock the babies in the cradle song.
Start off and see if I can get in key with you.
Hab ich aber oxen, was sie brocken, lockschen, ei wunder, ebbe wunder, wie die oxen brocken, lockschen, das ist mir a wunder. Hab ich aber bären, was sie stieber kehren, ei wunder, liebe wunder, wie die bären stieber kehren, und die oxen brocken, lockschen, das ist mir a wunder. Hab ich aber ziegen, was sie kinder wiegen, ei wunder, ebbe wunder, wie die ziegen kinder wiegen, und die bären die Begehren und die Ochsen brocken, Lochsen, das ist mir ein Wunder. Hab ich aber Hint, was sie machen Tint. Ei, Wunder, ebbe, Wunder, wie die Hint machen Tint. Und die Ziegenkinder wiegen und die Bären die Begehren und die Ochsen brocken, Lochsen, das ist mir ein Wunder. Hab ich aber Hähner, was sie kleiben Spänner. Ei, Wunder, ebbe, Wunder, wie die Hähner kleiben Spänner. Und die Hint machen Tint. Und die Ziegenkinder wiegen und die Bären die Begehren und die Ochsen brocken, lockschen, das ist mir ein Wunder.
Oh, it would take me an awful long time to try and learn that, though.
Oh, there are more stanzas than that. Fegelich, backen begelich, and ketzlich, machen plätzlich, and so forth. Lots of them.
Do they all speed up like that as you go on?
Mm-hmm.
Last year, for the first time in my life, some friends took me to a community seder, and I heard a song a little bit like that.
My grandfather sang it a little bit different. It was like a chant, and I don't quite remember the Aramaic, but he said, and then all the family, but the kid for the two zuzim that father bought in the marketplace, you know, piles up too.
I wonder what the reason for the popularity of these songs. I don't know. I love them myself. I think it's because you have this strict arithmetical logic to it. You add one thing to another, but then nothing else seems to connect. It's like a panoramic view of life, a little bit of everything. I mean, after all, what does 11 ladies dancing and 12 pipers piping have to do with Christmas? It's just, you look at all life, and then you tie it together by the numbers.
It's almost as if the environment wanted to be strict according to numbers, and the people laughed and had fun.
Yeah,
and imaginative, you know, they imagined all sorts of things.
You know the song from the Southern Negro tradition, children go where I send thee, how shall I send thee? I'm gonna send you one by one, one's for the little bitty baby was born in Bethlehem. I learned that from Sonny Terry, the harmonica player, and someday he's gonna be on this program too, I hope. And we can catch him when he's in New York sometime. And once there's another kind of a cumulative song, which my brother-in-law's friend, a longshoreman out in San Francisco, taught me. He said his father used to do it with the kids. And he'd say, now repeat after me. He'd say, one big fat hen. So the kids would repeat, one big fat hen. And he'd say, two ducks. Now they have to repeat two of them. Now how good's your memory out there? See if you can keep with me. One big fat hen, two ducks. Three plump partridges. Got all three now? See if you can get it. One big fat hen, two ducks, three plump partridges, four screaming wild geese. Got all four now? One big fat hen, two ducks, three plump partridges, four screaming wild geese, five limerick oysters. One big fat hen, two ducks, three plump partridges, four screaming wild geese, five limerick oysters, six bones from a Macedonian horse. How you doing? One big fat hen, two ducks, three plump partridges, four screaming wild geese, five limerick oysters, six bones from a Macedonian horse, seven sailing ships sailing from Orinoco to Madagascar on Prince Kilgore's wedding day. Okay, here we go. You got it? One big fat hen, two ducks, three plump partridges, four screaming wild geese, five limerick oysters, six bones from a Macedonian horse, seven sailing ships sailing from Orinoco to Madagascar on Prince Kilgore's wedding day, eight elegant elephants embarking for Europe. Oh, I could go on. It goes on. Nine nimble noblemen nonchalantly nibbling nonpareils. 10 tipsy tailors timidly torturing a terrified titmouse. 11 Corinthian columns careening cautiously, closely contiguous to the covered catacombs of a Catholic convent. 12 turbulent tomtits twittering tumultuously in the top of a tall tamarack tree. 13 thirsty thespians thriftily thumbing through 30,000 theological theses.
How do you remember it all?
Well, I didn't think I did, because I hadn't done this for years, but I looked it up, and once you get the first word, you're set. maybe that's the reason for it. It's maybe the numbers help you remember it.
It
gives you something to start off remembering.
It's terrific.
Oh.
No one, you can't easily pick that up. You've got to remember that since childhood. Did you hear it when you were a little boy?
No, I just learned that about 8 years ago for the first time.
So difficult.
I can remember lots of things, not the grocery list, but I can remember songs. I figure, you know, that here's a Yiddish tradition, what we call it, non-Jewish tradition, but if we went back further, far enough, I bet we're descended from the same things. Probably 10,000 years ago, there was some caveman sitting by a fire, and he probably had a song about one, two, three, at least counting up to 10.
Well, it is said, and scholars have determined this, that the first number songs only went up to five because they were the five fingers on the hand. And then they went up to 10. And they went in groups of five. And then later on, they went into seven, depending upon tradition. Now, for instance, the number 13 is not considered lucky in the Western tradition, right? But in Jewish lore, it's a lucky number. And so our number song that is sung at the Passover Seder, at the Passover feast table, goes up to 13, while your number song at Christmas only goes up to 12, right?
Yeah.
That's it. Because with us, 13 is a lucky number.
Sing just a little bit of that again, just a little bit.
Well, I don't know it exactly, but I'll sing you the tune. Well, perhaps I remember the first line. Echad mi yodeya, echad ani yodeya, echad eleheni sheba shamayim uboret. Starts with the Lord. First is the Lord, and then the two commandments, and then the three patriarchs, and then the four mothers, so forth. All back into the Bible. And this chant, of course, is in our family traditional. It may not be traditional for others.
Well, my advice to anybody out there is if you got a family that likes to make music, look around and see what you have in your own family. Doesn't matter what family it is, because you might find something very much to surprise you. And it might be a song your grandmother knew, your aunt, your uncle, your cousins, and you can mix it up. Everybody in this world is going to be bilingual one of these days. We're not just going to speak English. I've traveled to different countries, and I can tell you for sure that most people in other countries know two languages. Went to Indonesia, and everybody there was studying English. I went to Soviet Union. That's the first place I sang that Zhang Koya song, because I wanted to see what they would think of it. It got tremendous applause. Hey, John Koya. They loved the song. I used to have to sing it twice. And maybe to end off, let me sing you a song which some of you may recognize as being played on the radio right now. The words are 3,000 years old, and they're in your tradition as well as mine. And all I did was put a new tune to it. To everything, turn, 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 there is a season. Turn, 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 and a time for every purpose under heaven. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to reap, a time to kill, a time to heal, a time to laugh, a time to weep. To everything, turn, 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 there is a season. Turn, 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 and a time for every purpose under heaven. A time to build up, a time to break down, a time to dance, a time to mourn, a time to cast away stones, a time to gather stones together. To everything, turn, 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 there is a season. Turn, 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 and a time for every purpose under heaven. A time of love, a time of hate, a time of war, a time of peace, a time you may embrace, a time to refrain from embracing. To everything, turn, 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 there is a season. Turn, 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 and a time for every purpose under heaven. A time to gain, a time to lose, a time to rend, a time to sow, a time of love, a time of hate, a time of peace. I swear it's not too late. To everything, turn, 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 there is a season. Turn, 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 and a time for every purpose under heaven. You sing that along with me. We gotta go now, but this is a wonderful old poem, Book of Ecclesiastes, 3,000 years ago. Some people say that King Solomon was Ecclesiastes, I don't know. But try singing that chorus with me. Do everything, turn, 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 there is a season. Turn, 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 and a time for every purpose under heaven. To everything, turn, 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 there is a season. Turn, turn, turn,
so fine. I'd weave a magic strand of rainbow design, of rainbow design. In it I'd weave the bravery of women giving birth. In it I'd weave the innocence of children over all the earth. Children of all earth, far over the water, I'd reach my magic band to every city, through every single land, through every land. Show my brothers and my sisters my rainbow design. Bind up this old world with hand and heart and mind, hand and heart and mind. Oh, had I a golden thread and needle so fine, a magic strand of rainbow design. Oh.